velvet, yeah, to give him a smile. It's good to get high but never come down. It's good to be king of your own little town. Yeah, the world day. When your bulldog barks and your canary sings, you're out there with winners. It's good to be king. It helps to make friends. It's good to meet girls, a sweet little queen who can't run away.
At the end of the hill, we figure out the riddle.
So you guys sound a little frustrated.
No, we're not really frustrated. We're just deciding which girl on our team week we should vote off. It's a tough choice. Should we vote off Cassidy or Cassidy, guys? I don't know. We figured out. Cassie has a downfall. Then she's sunburned. Cassie has a downfall that her legs can't walk. And that's supposedly sunburned. And she hates camping and she's cold all the time. We can point out to the camera that we know the answer. We figured it out after catching up the hill at the snowman. Point out. So she goes back down. I'm going to walk over and get the answer right again. And then, we can go back. And then I got to run up the hill.
Anything else you want to say?
No. Okay. Nope. The Paiute, we're going to also rename ourselves after the vote out. The Paiute Trio. The Paiute Trio. I like that too. Overall, I slept really warm last night. I think we should have dunked Tom in the river. No. I wish I'd had matches a little longer. We went out that we weren't too sad about the first challenge because at least they only got one more granola bar than we did overall. We figured it out. We actually got three granola bars, they only got four. So I didn't care that much. So let's start.
warning.
So people can actually understand you.
And the next person would say it as well, and it kept going until my sister Cassidy took all the little marshmallows. I think she had 15 in her mouth, maybe 20.
So we got up to like 7 or 8, and Cassidy, because of her sunburnt cheeks, dropped out because it was hurting her.
I was amazed at how many marshmallows everyone was able to fit in their mouth and still be able to say the words. I really was surprised actually when Cassidy spit it out. I didn't think, I was sure I would try to fit at least a couple more in there.
She was gagging. It was gross. So then she finally spit him out. She lost.
Oh yeah, and then John left his coat. Forgot about that.
All my work and endless measures never seemed to get me there. Walk a mile, still moving it now, even though I'm tired too damn hard. I'm trying so hard, this world can turn me down, but I won't turn away, and I won't again run, cause I'm not built that way.
correct?
Blackhawk.
All right.
That's a cool name.
If you had to say you've learned one thing about playing this game, what is it that you'd say you've learned so far?
It's harder to kick people out than I thought it would be.
In what way?
Because Brian really wanted to be here, and I really hated kicking him out the first time, and he even just went to the other tribe, but still, you know, kicking him out that first time sucked. He was pretty bummed about it.
What, as far as voting people off and things like that, what type of things have you, what caused you, for instance, in that case, to vote out Brian Ray? Obviously, that was kind of a surprise.
We voted out Brian Ray only because we wanted to keep the knowledge of Dad, because we felt that, you know, Casty was their slow component, and Dad was our slow component, but, Dad had a lot more knowledge. He's won us a lot more events because of the knowledge, and so we decided to keep him in the end.
So you think it's paid off then?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Because Dad would have gone to the other team.
At this point here, the tribes have now unified. Obviously, the strategies changed a little bit. How do you think that that's affected the gameplay?
I think that Dad is a deciding vote. I think whoever wins, whether it be Wayne or Jeff or me or Troy, it's all on Dad's head. And he knows it, and he hates where he's at right now. I think he says like that's why he wished that he would have been kicked out earlier.
So that he wouldn't have had to have voted?
Mm-hmm. Because he wants to vote for himself. But if he votes for himself, then Wayne and Jeff win.
Okay. What so far to you has been your leading strategy to win the game? What are some things you've done that maybe other people don't?
I didn't think that necessarily I was going to win. I thought, you know, me and Troy could get to the end. Just because we have a strong connection between us that, you know, we want to make it to the end and that we both work really hard to get there. I think that by us winning the events and getting to where we are now, that we have 3-2, that's our best shot at winning because we can just vote them out.
Perfect.
Funky little red light. Go ahead.
At this point here, you've made it to the final five. Congratulations.
Yeah.
At this point now, you've spent one night with your tribe. What is the one thing you think you've learned about the other tribe?
I don't know. I would say the majority of the thing I've learned about the tribe is the fact that unless it's actually challenging, they're actually doing stuff that's actually competitive. It's just laugh around joke time, which is cool.
What about you guys' tribe? How do you think your tribe has handled the merge?
Well, Jeff kind of fell asleep, so I don't know. Jeff really didn't. Besides that, it was pretty cool because that's one benefit of doing the survey with everyone you know. So we just sat around and laughed about Starley's non-talking to her car's place for most of the night. So, wasn't bad.
If you had to sum up, if you had to explain what your strategy is in a couple words, what would you say is your strategy at this point out?
Get the immunity idol.
Just continue to win immunity. All right.
Or continues a strong word since I've only won it once.
Perfect. Good luck, Blackhawk. Can I ask you this? At this point now, we just talked. We've been interviewing those of you that made it to the final five.
Yeah.
What do you think has gotten you to the final five?
I don't know. Just picking the right people to vote off and winning immunity for our tribe.
You know, obviously you guys have won all the immunities but one.
Yeah.
The one you lost caused you to vote off a person.
Yeah.
There's obviously been some surprise about how that happened.
Yeah, since our person went on the other team, that was kind of fun.
What, do you guys think you chose the right person?
Yeah, I think we did.
Why do you say that?
Well, because our last immunity was supposedly knowledge-based. And we did pretty well with our team members.
As far as learning things about being a team or having a strategy to win, what is it that you think you're going to use to try and get to the final one?
I don't know.
Are you just going to continue to do the same strategies? I mean,
yeah.
As far as now, I mean, the tribes have unified. Do you think that's affected things at all?
Not really. We still have more of our people.
So you guys think your tribe will carry out and end up being the final three?
Maybe. Possibly. Not for sure, though.
All right, if you had to say you've learned one thing playing the game, what would you say it is?
The ground is really hard.
Cool, thanks.
Thank you.
Yesterday the tribes merged. What do you think? What is your first impressions with the other tribe?
We have matches.
You have matches. What have been, as far as combining camps, what has, last night you had to move all their stuff over, everything like that. Was there any contention or how did that go?
It was alright.
Any experience that you recall over of any others?
No.
OK, Okay, at this point here, you're one of the final five. Congratulations. What is your strategy going forward?
Just do as best as I can on the challenges and don't do anything stupid so I get voted off.
If you at this point now had to guess, looking at everyone around, and you had to say who's going to win, who would you say it is?
It's between Troy, Wayne, and Dad.
Perfect. All right, thanks. Blackhawk Tribe Final Five, congratulations. At this point now, a lot of people, especially after I think the Tribal Council yesterday, you probably thought that's where you were going to be done. Obviously, you're still here. What do you think? Was that a surprise to you?
Yes.
Were you expecting to stay? I mean, at what point was that decided that you were staying? Or, I mean, because obviously, at least even to us running this, we were quite shocked that the vote went the way it did.
Well, it was obvious because I had a choice. I could either break the tie and be gone, and be left here, or I could keep the tie the same and do another challenge. It wasn't a hard choice.
All right, at this point now, you are part of the final five. You've seen the tribes unify. Have you noticed anything as far as the tribes unifying, and how has that gone as far as joining the two tribes together?
It's pretty good, except for our alliance is going to kill them.
Yeah, I think that both of you and they are beginning to feel that, and hopefully the immunities and other things are going to help out with that. At this point here, obviously, by tonight, there's going to be one survivor. If you had to look right now at everyone there and say, who's going to win, who would you say it is?
Starly.
You think Starly. Okay. At this point, going on in, what do you think is your number one strategy?
I need a campaign a lot better.
All right. You'll follow.
Ready, set, go! I wouldn't jump, I would roll.
Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Stop the rock. Can't stop the rock. Can't stop the rock. Come on.
over a minute.
Hey Dad, you gotta look at these tiny faces. Okay, congratulations Troy on winning immunity.
Yay!
Troy is immune from this voting off. In a second when we ask you all to vote, you will not be allowed to vote for Troy, however you may vote for anyone else.
How did we vote for Troy? Can you?
Troy, first of all, let's repeat that question. Was it worth it?
Yeah.
Obviously, we had a little incident with a little bit of vomiting going on and Troy and vomiting going hand in hand together. What happened down there?
I drank a lot of water and then went swimming. Bad combination.
All right. Okay, let's go ahead and pan to Wayne. In fact, I need you to speak up a little bit because we got to record your voice over the river. We saw you swim all the way to shore, but then you didn't quite make it out of the water. What happened on your side?
I got to the point, got to the shore, and I said, nope, you got to get on the shore. I said, I don't care anymore. That's what would happen. I said, you know what? Immunity Island just isn't worth it. At that point, I floated out of the water a little bit. I did an impression of a beached whale, and then washed off my legs and my stuff, and then came ashore. But I did get a time of 3 minutes.
Straight up the air.
Alright, well let's go ahead and ask Starty a question. Starty, you find yourself right in the middle of the log there. How are you able to get that seat?
I sat down. It's lovely.
you seemed a little frustrated earlier on in the immunity challenge before. What are your feelings looking back at it?
I'm glad that I copped out of the swimming. Because two people got sick and I'm dry and feeling good.
Awesome. All right, well, what we're going to do is over here to our left is the immunity challenge tree. Of course, you vote your people
who's
out.
Who's left?
My left.
Oh.
You, one by one, in the order you are sitting on the log, we'll ask you to come over, vote. You won't need to write it down. Just tell us who you're voting for, why, how you came to that conclusion as such. When we come back, I'll ask you all to turn your lights on. We'll read the votes, and the person in the majority will ask you to extinguish that light and to stay with us while the rest of you return to camp. Okay, let's go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and tell us who you are voting for and why.
I think I'm going to vote myself out because they're most likely going to vote me out because I know that Starling and Troy have an alliance and they're probably going to take it.
So you're going to vote for yourself? You don't want to throw that vote at somebody, maybe one of those two? Okay. Good.
Does that matter? There it goes. Now it's on.
Who are you voting for and why?
I'll probably vote for Dad. For nothing other than not to vote him off, just tie the vote on the first one. Because I believe that Troy and Starty are going to vote together, and I believe they're probably going to vote for me because they were talking about that what happens if he wins the immunity challenge, and I don't believe, strength based, that they believe Jeff will win it. I believe I'm going to be the biggest competitor in the strength based. Because if they tie it, then they may have to change their vote.
Okay. Who are you voting for and why?
I'm voting for Wayne.
You need to sit just a little out so you can get on here. You can move closer to the camera if you want.
I'm voting for Wayne because he's the strongest opponent. And even if it's not a strength, whatever the next challenge may be, I think that Wayne would be a harder opponent and he might win the immunity and then we would be kind of lost. So we're going to vote for Wayne.
Okay. You're voting for and why?
I'm going to vote for Wayne because I think he's the strongest link and he's most likely to take me out of the movie.
Okay, who are you voting for and why?
I'm not voting for anybody.
You have to vote for someone.
This is a really hard vote because the people I'm with want somebody off. But I want off.
So, you're voting for yourself or should you vote for someone? Okay.
Have them come up. They don't need them.
Okay, as soon as we reach a majority, that person will be asked to leave. In the case of a tie, you will be allowed to re-vote again and have a chance to change your vote. The votes win is following in no particular order. One vote for Jeff. One vote for Dad. One vote for Dad. One vote for Wayne. And one vote for Wayne. We have a two-way tie between Wayne and Dad. Therefore, you'll each be asked to re-vote.
Oh, we gotta walk back over there.
Yes, you do. You will need to say either I'm leaving my vote the same or I'm changing it to this person and why. We'll ask you all to stand up and go back, voting for and why.
I'm gonna change my vote to me.
And why is that?
Because my group expects it.
Okay.
Is that, do you feel that's a legitimate reason to vote for him?
No, I do not.
But you're still gonna do it.
Vote for me. I didn't campaign good enough again.
Then why don't you remain how you are?
Because it'll be another tie.
Yeah, and then you guys go against.
Well, if it's a tie, then there's a challenge.
That's okay. That's
okay. What are you doing?
I'm keeping the same.
Keeping your vote the same.
Yes.
Go.
I'm going to vote for Wayne still.
Okay. Who are you voting for?
Change it to Jeff.
To Jeff. Okay. Who are you voting for and why?
Myself.
Okay.
I have batteries.
Your lights are on. These lights represent your life cycle. The votes will be read again. If, in the case of a second tie, a knowledge challenge will be done between the two people who are tied.
Yes!
The votes go as follows in no particular order. One vote, Jeff. Two votes, Jeff. One vote, Wayne. Two votes, Wayne. Three votes, Wayne. Wayne, you have been eliminated. We turn off your lights. You'll ask to be remained.
I remain.
Yep, the rest of you stand. And you are asked to return to your camp.
Still got that. Come. Pizza!
Look at me! Pizza. Look at me!
Okay,
look at me.
This is the last of this type of immunity challenge. There are four of you left from what started at 10 people. Congratulations once again on making it this far. I'm going to have our vice president in chief here hold up a certain item for you. Do you want to grab your item and hold it up for them to see?
Mine.
I know. Can anyone, what is this?
A pick. Stick.
Not a pick?
Or a tomahawk.
Tomahawk. One of the skills of the Indian is the tomahawk, the ability used in war, but also used in skill. Lumberjack, same thing.
So, as you're all sitting there on the log, we're going to practice throwing tomahawks at you.
And you have to practice your dodging ability. No, the last challenge is a tomahawk toss. We will take you to that location in just a second. Before we do so, let me explain the rules. Everybody will have a chance to toss. The rule of the game is the first person to hit it twice. However, it goes in rounds. In other words, let's say Troy hits it twice, and in the same round, Starly hits it twice. If that was the case, they would keep, only those two would continue to throw until one of them missed.
How many times do you throw in the round?
You get to throw one throw per round.
Gotta hit two throws per round.
Okay. So, what I would like you to do is in a second, we're going to have you go ahead and pick your tomahawk and then we will take you to the starting area. Wait.
He said wait. No, you
go ahead.
Do it first.
Cheater.
Come on, Starty.
No, way short.
No, that was too bad.
Did anybody hit?
I did.
That's it?
Don't hit me, please.
Oh. Hey, don't throw.
Are we ready?
Nice shot!
Wait, isn't that it?
No, now it's Troy and Dad.
Come on, Troy.
Yes, think about this way. If you win the immunity idol.
Hey. Why are you throwing? Yes, you're not here.
Well, I have to throw again now. What is that?
Wait. We hit twice. We hit twice.
No, we hit one.
The first time was a practice round.
We only hit one. Starting twice!
Miss!
Oh my gosh!
Can I go in for you?
Has anybody hit twice?
No.
Oh. Okay.
Dad.
I just noticed how close I am.
I was way out of there.
Jeff for the win.
Did Jeff hit once?
Yep.
Yep. Good job.
That is it.
That's around?
No,
nobody else hit, so nobody else can hit twice.
I did.
Did you so hit? You have to hit two times in a row.
Oh, you do?
Oh, we
didn't know that.
Oh, we didn't know that.
Okay.
This is the second to last time that you will be allowed to vote for people. So at this point here, we're going to ask you just a couple questions. Number one, how does strategy change as the tribes get smaller?
Not much. It doesn't.
It's the exact same tribe?
Yeah. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Jeff, you're going to have to speak up a little bit so I can hear you. We know in this last challenge, you won the immunity idol, apparently pretty easily. How does that affect your hopes of winning, or, you know, were you expecting to win it, stuff like that?
I want to come in second so I don't have to plan for the next survivor.
Okay, any other comments before you vote? Anything you want to say, or, yes?
I'm old, I'm tired, vote for me, yeah!
Good campaigning.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a fine campaign.
I vote for you.
Yeah! I vote!
Okay, who do you vote for and
me.
Why? Why?
I want to get out. I want to sit in the shade.
Okay.
I'm old. I'm an old person.
Next!
Next!
Who do you vote for and why?
I'm going to vote for Brother Simon and...
Why?
Because, like you said, he's old and tired and he wants shade.
Okay. Who are you voting for and why?
I'm voting for Brian because he wants to leave and he's injured.
Okay. Who are you voting for and why?
I'm voting for Dad because that was in our plan. He wants to go next.
All right. You should all turn your flashlights on.
My light's already dying.
It's getting old.
We will announce the votes in the order. If a majority is given, you'll be asked to immediately extinguish your light. In case of a tie, we will re-vote. In case of a tie of that time, whoever received the most votes at that time. Okay, the votes were as follows. One vote, Dad. One vote, Starly.
Starly?
Two votes, Starly.
Starly?
Three votes, Starly.
What?
Turn off your light.
You're making that
yeah,
up.
Yeah, that doesn't work.
You're a big liar. It one actually vote. Goes four votes for Brian.
Yay!
He's out of here.
Extinguish your light.
Like, this
you
is
will
Brian.
Remain.
Oh, wait. You guys
and stand.
I didn't vote for you.
I know I didn't vote for you.
And stand. You may remove yourself from that item. The rest of the challenges will be taking place on that log.
Okay.
The last survivor. Immunity challenge. Survivor. This is the last immunity challenge entirely. First of all, Jeff, will you please toss me the immunity item?
It's easily to eat up.
There are three of you left. For many of you, this is a great surprise. Starly, I know you didn't expect to be here. What do you think it turned to the tide of events and got you here?
We stuck to our strategy. It's amazing. We had a good team.
Why do you think your strategy worked?
Because we had a strong team. We worked good as a team together. And we decided early on, like, it was either going to be us staying together or the other team was going to kick us out and kind of stuck together.
All right. Well, in this tribal challenge, we'll see how well you knew the other people who are not sitting in the seats that you are in right now.
I totally discussed it. Sorry.
Yeah, very.
It doesn't matter. We'd already done this. So, I'm going to ask you a number of questions. After I read the question, one by one, you will stand. You will walk down to the tribal council area and tell your answer to Dax.
Maybe not so far.
Why can't we just write them? Like they do on the show?
Don't have enough.
We could pass it.
That's all right.
I like that because then you can all show it at one time.
That's okay.
We
can go down there. It's just the camera goes crazy.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So, yeah, are you all ready? Do you have any questions as far as the rules?
There it goes. I don't know why I did that.
Okay. Which survivor, when asked the question, if I could wish for one thing, said I would wish for no war? Okay.
Question number two.
Did Jeff get it right?
What person, when surveyed and asked, where were you born, gave the answer of Ogden, Utah? Next question. What survivor, when surveyed and asked, what is your most embarrassing moment, responded, walking into a pool twice? Whoa, you're not up. Okay, next. What survivor, when surveyed, was asked the question, what is your most favorite activity? And the answer given was kissing. Next question. What survivor, when asked if I could wish one thing, responded, to be able to live comfortably without bills of any kind? Okay, for the last question. What survivor, when surveyed, said that they had 9 siblings?
It can't be somebody sitting up here.
You're up. Yes, you're correct.
Jeff.
Go.
Okay. You have been tested. You have been proved. And the camera will change to point at you.
And you have been found wanting.
Wait, what am I doing with this?
Of the camera. For the last survivor item that guarantees you a chance in the top two, and a chance at the $1 million that we aren't giving you.
$1 million.
The first question was asked. Let's go back through the eight through the pages.
Let's go through your answers and say.
Cassidy, they're done. Okay, Brian.
The survivor that said he would wish for no war. Was Brian Ray.
Oh yeah!
The survivor that was born in Ogden, Utah was Brian Salmon. The survivor...
Who knew that?
The survivor whose most embarrassing moment was walking into a pole twice was Cassidy.
How'd you know that? How did you know that?
She said she walked into the pole twice in her house.
No.
Oh well,
that's
right.
The survivor who said his favorite activity was kissing.
Wayne.
Was Wayne.
Yeah.
The survivor who said that if I could wish for one thing, it would be able to live comfortably without bills of any kind, was John.
John.
Nobody got that.
The survivor that said he had 9 siblings was Brian Ray.
And I switched it.
Okay, total scores.
Who'd you say?
Troy answered 3 of those correct.
I forgot that I counted one of them.
Starly answered 4 of them correct.
Nice.
Jeff answered 7 wrong. Jeff got 1 right. Starly,
yes,
you win the
award. Yeah! Look at that.
I love
that.
Troy,
Jeff had 37.
You will, all of you should turn your little flashlights on. Jeff, turn your flashlight on.
Yes, flashlight next to
him. Turn it on. Jeff, turn your flashlight off. You're extinguished from the game. You will ask to be removed and take a seat over here.
We didn't even have a vote.
Or if you're hungry, there's...
Welcome to the final survival champion meeting. This right here will discover which of the final two survivors will win. Prior to this, we are going to give one chance for each of these survivors that did not make it to this point to ask either one of you or both of you a single question. That question can be of anything they want, and you should answer that.
Really?
When they are done asking their questions.
Anything.
Troy, what is your bank account number, Pepper?
Accurate. 1, 2, 3, 4.
When they are finished, I will give each of you a chance to explain to them why they should vote for you as the survivor champion.
It's that they have to ask truthfully.
The lone survivor. You must answer truthfully.
No, we don't. We can't
hold
that.
I can't hold that. Okay, we will go ahead and start with Brian Ray.
Did you vote for me?
When the first time?
Who are you talking to?
Did you
who are you talking to?
Both of you. He can ask you both.
I know, I was just wondering.
Yeah.
Okay. Brian, I told you before we went.
Yes, I know.
I am voting for you.
Yes, so did I. I thought so.
Jeff.
Just making sure my calculations work.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, 3-1 every day.
No, Jeff? It wasn't 3-1.
Where would you plan on doing it next year, Troy?
Would I plan on doing it next year?
Or September.
Or in September.
Or whenever it is next.
Doing it in early September.
Yeah. That's a hard question. Probably by a lake or something. No, there's not as much driving on the really rough terrain.
Where would you have it?
I'd have it in Bear Lake.
In Bear Lake?
Yeah.
In.
You're not allowed out of the water unless you're voted out.
Yeah.
I'm a little pruny.
When you ask the questions, you want to yell them out a little bit because they're kind of hard to hear.
Who's up?
Jeff.
Jeff.
What will be the best thing that we'll do on the next survivor?
Wow, this is great. We're planning.
I know.
Can we plan a little agenda here? I can. Wow.
Who are you asking first? Jeff?
It's just a general question. Got it.
Well, because I planned it so well. I would say the funnest thing we would do is... oh my gosh, I'm going to say to have, we're going to have pulleys, and then you have like your little tag on that you have the metal. I forget what those call those. Are they called pulleys?
No.
With rope, like rock climbing rope. And you have to go up to the tree and it's wrapped around this whole maze and asks a question and you have to pick like one of the answers and pick a rope that you will click onto and try to follow it. Wow. And whoever gets through the maze first.
Roy?
What'd
you say? I'd say water ski.
Wow.
How do you say water ski?
I don't know.
I wanna know who came up with the alliance first. Who approached the other one and asked him to join it?
Did I?
Yes, remember when we were walking up the road.
What'd I say?
I
guess
I brought
it
up.
Yeah.
Cassidy.
If you guys were on different teams, would you have made the
Say that again. I can't hear you at all.
If you guys were on different teams, would you have made an alliance anyway?
With each other?
No, with somebody else on your team.
I would have.
Probably. I would have, yeah, probably.
Okay, now we will start with Starly. Starly, you are allowed to give one talk to the survivors and tell them why you think you deserve to win.
You get 15 seconds.
I'm going to say that in September, it's unlikely that survival will happen because a lot of us are going to be in school. I have homework. Anyway, so the next real survivor won't be able to happen until next summer. I would think so, and he's going to be on his mission. And you can still vote for him, and that's fine, but then it's just left up in the air again. And I've seen the show a billion times. I've applied twice. Hello. So I have more, like, insight.
Time.
Okay.
Troy?
Okay. 15 seconds. I'm giving my mission, but I would pass it off to Starby if I did get it. Sorry that it rocks and she loves Survivor and she's really good at it.
Yeah, why do you think you deserve to win here, though?
I didn't say I don't care. Why do I deserve? Because I threw up. And I'm still here.
Okay.
We can discuss this.
Each of you, each of you will be given about 15 seconds to decide. While we're moving the camera,
okay.
Once we move the camera, we'll ask you each to come over to the original voting area and we'll ask you to vote.
That's
not on. I am going to vote for Troy. Troy needs to win. True, he won't be here to plan it. I don't care. I'm not a big fan of alliances. In fact, I believe that survival should be just that, survival of the fittest. Oh well. Sorry, Star.
I think that Troy should win because he worked his butt off for that immunity and everybody else chickened out like chickens and threw up because of it, so that's why I think he should win.
Voting for.
I want to make Troy win.
Why?
Because I think he'll plan it better and he'll make it funny.
I don't see the red light. Okay, I'm voting Troy, because Troy is much better than Starly. Starly has had the entire time she brought it up, and she should be voted off. I could vote her off, but I can't. So I vote Troy. I've had my reason to vote her off. That's why.
What red light?
We're voting for Starlight because that's the plan. Sticking to it.
Does it say winner?
This beautiful trophy.
Cool. Oh, that's cute.
Soul Survivor, Alpine 2002.
Where'd you get that done?
Very cool.
As well as...
Here, you want to...
Microwave popcorn. 200,000.
200,000. Our lives never break.
A $5 gift certificate to Hollywood Video.
Beer. Good.
And a six pack.
Lower. There you go.
Six pack of beer.
Root beer.
And that's what we need.
I don't want to hear about your food anymore.
Would all of you please return to the seats you're sitting in before?
Wait, me included?
Oh, before? Oh.
Here is the votes as they were given, not in any particular order.
That's my seat.
Too bad.
One vote.
I voted you off your seat.
Six. One vote, Troy. Two votes, Troy. Three votes, Troy. Four votes, Troy. One vote, Starling.
Rude.
The winner of Alpine 2002 is...
people.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Sorry.
Troy.
Thank you.
And for
second place,
Jolly Ranchers.
Well, we quickly traded over to
that was unbelievable. You guys are rude.
Okay, for the exit.
Right. How do you think the people feel that you voted off?
Go ahead and pause it.
I voted for you.
He hasn't asked me anything.
You just count saying whatever you want.
Oh, well, it's lame because I want to see you doing it in September and I won't be. And I won't if Troy asks me to do what I want because it was gay. If they all want to vote me out, that's fine.
Yay, I won. Yay, okay.
What do you wish to say before we end the weekend?
Yes,
go pizza.
I suck. Go pizza, is all I have to say. Overall, I think everyone did a really, really good job.
Well, I know. Well,
I think everybody did a really good job, except for me.
Well, was there anything that surprised anybody, something you didn't think was going to happen that did? Or?
How much Starlight stayed up with me as I was hiking across that lake. I wasn't planning on having to exert myself that much.
On the paddle across the lake?
Oh yeah, I didn't even get any gain on her until about halfway across.
Was anybody shocked about how well Jeff stayed up with Troy? They were head to head.
Oh yeah.
I was surprised, but I literally
was worried.
He's ahead!
Only then we had a little collision.
Well, what about you, Dad? What was the most surprising thing of the weekend?
How hard the ground is.
How hard the ground is.
My personal life for next time is an air pad.
Was anybody surprised when it started raining and we actually kicked you out of the vehicles?
No. After last time of canceling it in the rain, if it could have snowed and hailed, then Tom was still would have kept going.
Yeah, last time we canceled it for rain.
Nothing. It could have been raining the whole weekend. I'm pretty sure we would have kept going.
If you could have changed one thing, what would it have been?
Hiding Kathy in a little hole.
Me not coming.
Drinking a lot of water and going swimming.
Leaving John here. Amen.
I'll direct all the immunity things that I went on. I always lost immunity things, and it doesn't mean that they lost them.
Okay, what about Starley and Troy?
What about
if you changed one thing, what would it be? For Troy, probably nothing, you won.
What? To change? No, for drinking a half a bottle of water and then trying to swim. That was not the life.
Riding on someone's back down
the Yeah, we were just...
Okay. Last thing before we end.
Yes.
We'll start with Wayne. Wayne, what for you was the most memorable moment of the weekend?
Memorable moment? That probably was.
Same me.
Playing a dead well on the beach. That was kind of interesting. With Alvin going, you're like, what are you doing? Get up on the beach! Get up on the beach! Yeah, it was pretty funny. I enjoyed it.
It was funny.
Okay. Dad?
Huh?
Most memorable moment of the weekend.
Look at the pink flies.
Kissing the gravel up at the mine site.
Alright. Starly.
Go north.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll say the mine site.
Falling at the mine site?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably me too.
Troy?
Of course there is.
Watching them fly down the hill.
Okay. Jeff.
Go north, then east.
Yes.
Cassidy.
I would have to say on the way up, my team was scavenging everything possible.
Yeah, did you guys get video cameras at least of our camp before we figured everything down or anything?
No, we got pictures.
That's good, at least. That'll work.
Brian.
I have a tie between the. It's either the uranium, where I thought I was trying to get it metal, or...
What kind of metal do you have on you? Uranium.
Yeah. Or,
Hero.
Oh, damn, I can't remember the other. Anyways, yeah.
Okay, well, thank everyone for playing. It was fun. You're all really good. Let's have everyone wave goodbye as we fade out.
Summer through, I thought I'd found my dream in you. For me, you were the one, but that was yesterday, and yesterday's gone. We walked together hand in hand.